Well, we have made it to Monday after a beautiful weekend here in South Central Kentucky. We're on WCLU to talk about archives. To get the week started off right, let me say good morning to the one and only Sam Terry, who's kind enough to be with us to help set the history record straight here. Sam, how you doing?
I'm well. How are you today, Henry?
Doing real good. Just another beautiful Monday, and we've got a whole century's worth of things. A whole lot of heritage, and if this week winds up being like last week was, there was more. We revealed more little remembered secrets about this place. Maybe we'll do the same thing this week.
I would agree, and of course we're in a new month now.
That's
so
right.
Lots of new old news.
Well, let's go back 100 years to this very day, June 3rd of 1924, in the Glasgow Republican. The news reads that old Joe Goodman has sold another Garford truck. This one goes to R.E. Richardson at 88. Joe says the reason he can put out the Garford is because they can always be depended on to come back. That's right. You don't want to drive a, I guess he's saying about the customer, right?
Yes.
Not the truck in general.
I will admit I had to read that about 3 times to make sure it was saying what I thought.
That's right. Hey, I'll sell you this truck because you'll come get another one. Not that it'll make it home. That was 1924, a Garford truck. I've got to look up a Garford truck.
Well, it's easy to find on the internet.
Okay.
And they're neat looking, very compact trucks.
Uh-huh.
And I'm sure that people enjoyed owning those.
We have in 1934, Sam, the chance to look back through the eyes of the Hiceville News column in the Glasgow Times. We're going to summarize the news as follows. In 1934, among the out-of-town visitors in Hiceville for Decoration Day services were Mrs. Clarence Hatchett, Mr. Terry Hatchett, Miss Ada Hatcher, Mr. and Ms. Jess Hatcher, Mr. J.C. Hatcher, Miss Mona Hatcher, Mrs. Will Bethel, Mr. and Mrs. Roy Squires and family, Mr. Joe Dan Squires, Mr. and Mrs. Wilma Simmons, all of Glasgow, Mr. Charles Branstetter of Horse Cave, Mrs. W.E. Cook, Mrs. Trigg Caldell, Mrs. Clara Ross Wilson of Seymour, Mr. and Mrs. John Ross of Horse Cave, Mr. and Mrs. Theo B. Terry of Sonora, and Mrs. Molly Hatcher and daughter Maydell of Louisville. Where did they put all those people?
Well, I think they were all at the cemetery.
That's right. 1934. What the visitors for Decoration Day, they came.
And someone was keeping a list,
that's
clearly.
Right. Whoever was the Hiceville News columns at the time was good at record keeping.
They did,
sure.
And quite a large gathering of Hatchets and Hatchers.
That's
there.
That's right. That's right. Mm-hmm. Getting maybe some reacquaintances for sure. It was 1944. In the Glasgow Times, it was reported that Dr. W.A. Weldon has sold his apartment house on College Street to the city of Glasgow and will remodel the building inside and out so it can be used as a library. That's right. The remodel will start soon as 4 tenants presently live there have had time to find new living quarters. This community is deeply appreciative of Dr. Weldon's contribution to accomplishing an enduring step forward in Glasgow's cultural progress. Of course, Dr. Weldon is famous and revered for a lot of different things around here, not the least of which is his hard work in getting a library established, Sam.
Indeed.
1954, the news story of the day was that Barren County came through the 3-day Memorial Holiday period without a single accidental death or serious injury reported. It was described by authorities as one of the quietest long-period holidays in some time. Traffic mishaps reported involved property damage only, despite the fact that perfect weather conditions kept local highways and roads well-packed with traffic for 3 days. Now, you know, this is 1954, but back in all of the reporting just for this past weekend, for the Memorial Day weekend, they were predicting record travel, and I think it all came true.
I think so.
In 1954, it sounded to me like there was record travel as well, but very safe travel, too. Which
it was. And imagine, you know, 1954, we didn't yet have the Glasgow bypass,
right.
And that meant all of that traffic on 31 was coming straight through the middle of downtown Glasgow. So
everybody was
lots of cars around.
A festive holiday for sure. 1964, this day, Bill Wilmoth won the Memorial Day golf tournament, defeating Larry Alexander for the title. Randall Cook took third place. Alexander started his round with a hole-in-one on the 130-yard hole. Now, you're going to have to see Larry Alexander and just ask him about that because, you know, 1964 is a while back, but I guarantee he probably remembers it like it was yesterday.
Oh, I think he will.
And wouldn't we like to ask Randall Cook about that, too?
Yes.
What a fun guy indeed. 1974, honor students at Glasgow High School were announced. Jeff Johnson, valedictorian, and Thomas F. McKinley, the salutatorian. Very smart young fellows there from 1974 at Glasgow High School. 1984, the news is the Glasgow Scotty Band presented an old-fashioned concert for the public Thursday night. James Stuppy is the band director for Glasgow. Mr. Stuppy was an excellent band director. He wanted to get the youngsters out in the community, and he did that so well with that old-fashioned concert in 1984. 1994, the news is that Jennifer Reese, who is a senior at Transylvania University and a graduate of Glasgow High School, has been named to the Dean's List for the 1994 winter term. She is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Bob Reese of Glasgow, and a fine young lady indeed, Sam Terry.
Indeed.
It was 2004, the Barren County Progress reported that the 38th annual U.S. Bank Hall of Fame celebration to be held at the Barren River State Park Lodge. I don't have any of the recipients in this news story, but it's always, when you have made the Hall of Fame celebration of U.S. Bank and Citizens Bank before that, you had arrived to make that picture.
I would agree. It's quite an honor.
And the big headline in the Barren County Progress in 2014 this day was the news that the Cave City liquor vote is set for July the 22nd. So they're giving themselves plenty of time to battle it out for the liquor vote in Cave City with the news of that date here in 2014. So we've got a whole century's worth of things, and what a great start. Fabulous historical facts.
I would agree.
Thanks to some of the archivists and volunteers who helped put this together, not the least of which are the names of Kay Harbison, June Jackson, Marsha Laterra, and Sharon Gansey, and a whole lot more, folks. And we certainly appreciate all their hard work. We're going to review some more of that tomorrow here, Sam, on the archives.
I'll see you then.
Thank you.